Today, we're gonna vanish an object, but I'm not gonna use sleight of hand. I'm actually gonna use an illusion that will take place only in your mind. Welcome to Impossible Science. The more I do it, the weirder this gets. This is a crazy illusion. This pattern will actually make objects vanish to you. I know you don't believe me, so you're gonna have to try it. Here, take a look at this, you two. Stare at that green dot. Focus on the green dot, and you'll start to notice that the objects in your peripheral will start to vanish. But as soon as you refocus your eye, they're back. Here, try it again. Refocus your eye. That's right. They never went anywhere. Now, this is an illusion that's found in perceptual psychology, known as motion-induced blindness. It's kind of like a trick of the eye and a trick of the mind, where an object will actually vanish even though that stimuli is in plain sight. Never gets old, though. Even though this illusion was discovered in 1991 by V.S. Ramachandran and Gregory, who are two brilliant neuroscientists, even though they discovered the illusion, we still don't know exactly why this illusion is working. That's right, this is an impossible science going on right now. Now, there are four theories about why this illusion is working. The first one has to do with parts of your eye are being suppressed, and so therefore it deletes objects. The other one has to do with the idea that all your attention is focusing on the moving objects. But my two favorite ones have to do with your blind spot. That's the spot where your optical nerve attaches to the back of your eyeball, and that's where there's no light receiving cells. And because of that, your eye can't see that spot. There's actually a spot in your vision that your brain is constantly filling in. Now, one of the theories behind this illusion is that it defies logic, and so your brain deletes the foreground objects, meaning there's no way an object could be sitting on a moving background. For me, that doesn't make sense because you could totally have something on a piece of glass. So I decided to put my theory to the test, using it to see if I could replicate the animated pattern you saw at the beginning, but this time in the physical world. I'm gonna use the Sony Couve. It's super great. If you haven't seen me use this before, the Couve is fantastic for prototyping objects. You just upload your programs to it, and you can build anything with it. So, let's give it a shot. So if this is true, the thin sheet of glass shouldn't distract from your eyes, and the effect will take place, and the objects will vanish. This also means that if you happen to come across a moving background with a stationary object in front of it, the object could actually vanish right before your eyes.
Oh, I'm pretty excited because I know this is gonna work. I'm feeling pretty confident this thing's gonna vanish immediately.
Wow, as soon as this thing starts spinning, my brain is trying to process all those moving squares, and that is a lot. But there is a flaw to my plan. See, these pieces are actually translucent, so as the dark line goes behind it, it's actually blinking to me. I need to switch that out to something that doesn't blink. I'm gonna use a metal silver bolt. And I have a feeling this is gonna work great. Yeah, that totally works.
So if this is true, the thin sheet of glass shouldn't distract from your eyes, and the effect will take place, and the objects will vanish. This also means that if you happen to come across a moving background with a stationary object in front of it, the object could actually vanish right before your eyes.
If you liked the episode, click the like button and share it with your friends. And if you enjoy making the impossible possible through science, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.